Thanks, Janine. So I had the pleasure and honestly the challenge to work in the government support of housing in Third Street for the last 3 weeks. So let me explain a bit why. So number one, coming from Europe, I was asked, was this a cultural clash here in New York? And I have to say no, it was okay. Can social security be more different than in Europe compared to New York? I say yes. So when I came here, I needed a couple of days to understand what is this city about? What is happening here? Because the social security net in Europe is so much tighter that certain, we call it social careers that happen here, are impossible in Europe. And Europeans still complain all the time about social security in Europe. I think that's why it's so important to bring people here from Europe or from international to see what they're complaining about and how much. And then I think why was this place so perfect? I think this place is perfect because the people that are living there already went through a lot of changes in their life. So they have a history of shelter, they have a history of homelessness, they have a history of mental illness. But they already moved up again to permanent housing, which is a big and important step for them. And then they're in an environment where they're ready or hopefully can do the next step. So I think it helped me a lot to understand how these social careers in New York happen and what is needed to bring people back on track, I would point. So thinking about a little bit what I try to do and what we did there, we as UPS, as we always talk about making connections with all that we do with our customers and internally. And I think a lot of the work that is done there at Permanent Housing is about making connections. So I had an interesting conversation with Loretta, she's here on the right, about hey, how do you deal with your daily life? And she said, I'm just living in a tunnel. Because there are so many things going on the left, on the right, and in my position, in my situation right now, I cannot cope with my situation if I would move out of this tunnel. But what I experience every day is that Felipe and the team, they are creating an environment where all these residents have a chance to make connections with the group, which is the building, with the neighborhood, which would allow them to move on to the next step in their development, and with things that they can do outside. So we had basically two field trips. We did that in rather small groups, which I think was extremely valuable for them because they made connections as a small group, and then they take that back to these 52 units in permanent housing, and this then will allow them to navigate together in this smaller group now in the neighborhood. And then we tried to connect to other programs in Henry Street. So we took them to the Art Center because there was a quilting workshop, which is would be easy for them to connect to the neighborhood but they don't know, and maybe there's nobody that is ready to join them. So it's important to make small connections just between two or three other people to open up their mind and connect to the neighborhood. So these are the things that I would take back home to Europe, understanding that social security is totally different in other parts of the world. And it's all about making connections and allow people to get back on track and to cope with difficult situation, but to get out of it. And I think what Felipe and the team are doing there is creating an environment that allows them to make these connections. I think that's the way it works. Thanks for that. Now I hand it over to